Robbie Ray
will be the one towing the rubber for the Diamondbacks. Dan Plesac, what do you got?
Robbie Ray is quietly developing into one of the top left-handed pitchers in the game of baseball. Unfortunately, he gets lost in the shadow because of guys like Clayton Kershaw and Rich Hill. Big arm from Robbie Ray. Not a real big guy, but 95 to 97, good hard slider. His changeup has gotten better, and you'll know if he's on early because you'll see a lots of swings and misses. This guy can rack up the strikeouts.
Now the 2-1. And this will miss as well, so he's in danger of losing the leadoff man here tonight. It's 3-1 now. Well, guys, you take a look at this Diamondback squad as they begin play here tonight. They come in trying to rebound after a loss that snapped a modest three-game winning streak.
Yeah, Maddie, this is why we do what we do. Two first-place teams going to go at it today. Don't know how this is going to shake out. Is this playoff baseball? Come early a little bit. Interested to see how the managers go about it. We got some stars out on the field today.
Now the 3-2 pitch, and he lays off ball four. That's exactly what you want your leadoff man to do, work the count and get on base.
Yeah, the guy's been on fire lately, hitting anything close, so I think this is the way to go here. Get the bat out of his hands any way that you can.
And now here's the versatile outfielder, Albert Almora Jr. Lifetime numbers against Robbie Ray. He's a 375 hitter. He's taken him deep once. Ground ball sent back up the middle. He gets dirty, but he can't get there, and it's into center field.
Nice execution right there, Dan. Kept his front shoulder in, kept his hands inside the baseball, and ripped the base hit up the middle.
And if you're a pitcher right there, you can't get discouraged. Sometimes, even when you make a good pitch, the ball is going to find a hole somewhere. That one right up the middle.
Coming to the plate now, Chris Bryant, and he could give his guys an early lead if he can come through here. Zobrist over at second, Almora at first with no outs. Turned on that one and crushed it, just pulled it a little foul. Hoping to send him packing, pitch on its way. Fastball didn't miss by much, and it's a full count now, 3-2. Another full count pitch on its way. Lifted in the air to center field. Marte is right there, one down. With that, a look at the Cubbies starting lineup. D-Row, what do you got in this lineup in the series opener?
Well, Matty, you walk into this yard today and it's nothing but a hitter's park. But that could work against you at times. You have to stay within yourself. You can't just be turning and burning on everything. Stay within the game plan and know that a mistake doubles leaving this yard.
Here's Javier Baez. He had a couple of hits in yesterday's contest. Runners are at first and second with one away. And not a real good cut at that slider, and he's behind one and two. One and two, here it comes. Pulled high in the air out to left field. Peralta is under it. Two gone. Here's the young catcher, Wilson Contreras. Lifetime numbers against Robbie Ray. Two hits in seven tries. He also has one home run. Ready with the 1-1. Outside 2-1. For the current campaign, Contreras is carrying a slugging percentage under 350. Needless to say, he's not a big extra base hitter home run guy right here. The set and the 2-1. Two balls and two strikes now. Two down, runners at first and second. in the air to left. Here comes Peralta. He gets there to make the catch, and that ends the inning. Cubs strand a couple, and now the Diamondbacks will get their first turn at it. No score. Cole Hamels is the man towing the rubber for the Cubs in this one. What do we need to know here, Danny?
Hey, this guy's a fun guy to watch pitch. Not necessarily an overpowering guy. Has an ERA in the low threes. But one thing he knows how to do, he knows how to pitch, and he knows how to minimize damage. If you're going to have an ERA in the low threes in this day and age, you're doing a lot of things right. And this guy should be fun to watch in this one.
At the plate, Ketel Marte. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. Fouled away. Set to deal on a ball and two strikes. Hit back up the middle. Baez has it. And an off-balance throw is in time as he takes one away. Wow. With that, let's take a look at the hometown Diamondbacks lineup card. Who do you have your eye on, Dan?
Well, there's a lot of people hoping to see a turnaround from Ketel Marte. I thought they might get a lot more production out of him this year, but I look at the numbers with runners in scoring position, and his batting average is less than 250 in those spots. If you're a guy expected to drive in runs, you're going to have to hit a lot better than that.
Eduardo Escobar standing in. The 1-1. And this is lifted high in the air down the right field line. And he will make the play out there, and there are two away now. So bases are empty here with two gone. And up next, the outfielder, David Peralta. Hamels ready with the 1-1. In front of the changeup, and he can't keep it fair. Two strikes on him now. Hamels into the windup. 1-2 on its way. They try to come in with the fastball, but it's too far in, and it's even at 2-2. And there are the umpires working this one. Calling balls and strikes is Mr. Patrick Johnson.
You know, D-Roll, Patty Johnson, you know, decent strike zone, but isn't always super consistent. I think that's one of...
And we'll have to leave it there as this is strike three, and that will retire the side. So 1-2-3 go the Diamondbacks. Still no score. Anthony Rizzo stands in now. A couple of hits for him in four trips in yesterday's game. Popped him up. Avila over to his right. Makes the play, one away.
All right, here's the defensive alignment for the Arizona Diamondbacks. And guys, taking a look at this, this defense is going to have to be stout today. Starting pitcher with an ERA north of 5 usually spells some barrels being found by the opposition. So these guys better be on their toes in this one.
So in now for Chicago, Kyle Schwarber. And you see that average below the dreaded Mendoza line. Just off the outside that time, laid off for a ball. Right side, defense aligned perfectly. Marte fields it cleanly.
Hey, not an easy thing to do right there, D-Row, with that stacked infield on the right side. You hit it through where the shift is, have to hit that in the right place at the right time.
Yeah, he found a good result right there, Dan. Pitcher actually executed right there, got him to hit it where he wanted to, put good barrel, good contact on that ball, and was able to find the hole.
Standing in now, Cole Hamels. Got it back in time there, and it's 2-1.
Great decision there to pull back. Step number one in getting a sacrifice bunt down, make sure you bunt a pitch that you can handle.
Now the 2-1 pitch is going to be a sacrifice attempt as he gets it down. And you can't ask for much more out of a pitcher than that. The sacrifice works to perfection. Here's Jason Hayward now, and he's hoping to get things going at the plate. It's been a bit of a struggle for him in recent games. Right at the third baseman, and that'll end the inning. Cubs strand one. We'll go to the bottom of the second. No score. Up next for Arizona, Adam Jones. It was an 0-for-4 day for him in yesterday's loss. A 1-1 now to Jones. Can't find the zone there as he lays off the breaking ball. Well, guys, as we look at the Cubs coming into play here tonight, they came up a little short last time out, but they've still been one of the hotter teams around, winning 8 of their last 10 ball games.
Yeah, Matty, this team's in the grind part of their schedule right now. Just had a short homestand, able to say hello to the family, kiss the wife, tuck the kids in at night, and they're back on the road again. This should be interesting to see the energy this team plays with today.
The 3-1 pitch. He is swung on and missed. A full count now.
When you get yourself to a 3-1 count and you get a fastball, those are the ones you really want to punish. Couldn't get the bat on it, so we'll see if that comes back to haunt him.
Here's a ball for Rizzo over at first, and he'll step on first himself for the out.
Okay, here's how the Cubbies are lining up defensively. Let's take a look at catcher Wilson Contreras. This guy's got one of the best arms in the game. Think Gary Sanchez, but in the National League. Nobody wants to attempt stealing bags on this guy, and brings a powerful bat to the lineup.
So coming to the plate, Wilmer Flores. Previously against Cole Hamels, he's 4-for-14. Hit in the air to straightaway center, giving chase is Almora. He gets there, and that's the second out. So bases are empty here with two gone, and that means that Nick Ahmed will be the next to bat. Hamels peers in. Full count pitch on its way. High in the air down the right field line. On the move is Hayward. He tracks it down, and that will end the inning. Some of our nation's young minds and future leaders here in attendance. Yikes. Two complete, scoreless here on MLB Network. Here's Ben Zobrist now. He drew a base on balls his first time up. Hit out towards second. Throw to first in time, and the leadoff man is gone to start the third. And with that, there you get a look at what's happening in the race in the National League West. Stepping in and ready for another shot, Albert Almora. He reached on a single in his first try. And he takes a called strike two.
You know, hats off to the pitcher right there. You got a great hitter at the plate. It's early in the count, and he wanted to get ahead. Nice challenge pitch right there.
The 1-2. High and deep to left. This one's got plenty of distance, and it's gone. A solo shot here to left. Fourth home run for him on the season, and the Cubs are on the board first, 1-0. In now, Chris Bryant looks at a fastball low here, and it's full 3-2. One out, nobody on. A swing and a shot hit down the corner, and it'll fade just at the end and winds up a long foul ball.
It looked like, from our perspective, he gave up on that one a little too quick. And then tried to emergency hack late.
Lofted in the air out toward right center. Jones is under this one, and he's got it for out number two. So two are gone now in the Cubs' half of the third, and in the bat next, the versatile weapon, Javier Baez. Towards short. That's through for a base hit, and he's one for two now.
Dan, that hit right there extends his hit streak to 8 games. Are you aware of stuff like that?
No doubt about it right now. He's swinging the bat really well, and after that knock right there, hey, listen, 8 games is nothing to sneeze at, so you can say, hey, he's going a whole calendar week with getting at least one base hit, so there's a lot of positives going on right now.
Now a throw over to first. Baez leads off first with a pair of outs in the inning.
Baez
breaks from first. That's a strike to throw down. Not in time. He's in there at second.
That's pretty savvy base running, right? A lot of pitchers don't throw over twice in a row, so I think he was going on first movement, and it worked out nicely.
Here's the 1-2, yanked on the ground down the line. But this is a foul ball as the count holds steady at 1-2. From the stretch, the 1-2. He swings at the fastball here and lifts it into the air to shallow center. Marte is there, and he'll put it away to retire the side. Cubs are on the board first thanks to this solo home run. We played 2.5. It's now 1-0 Chicago. Here's the catcher, Alex Avila. 7, 8, and 9 to start the home third.
Not much going on offensively so far for these guys. 6 up, 6 down. We'll see if the bottom part of the lineup can get something going.
Well, the home crowd seems a little restless, so I'm sure they'd appreciate it. And it's fouled away. Once again, a 3-2. And he fouls this one off. And he turns this one around high and deep to center field. This one's down. It's the first hit for Arizona, and it's going to be for extra bases. And he's going to get to second now with nobody out.
Yeah, it looked like the center fielder got a fairly good jump on this ball, but he just doesn't have enough hops to bring it in. And once it's by him, you know he was going to get at least a double.
So striding in, Jake Lamb, as he'll look to bring home that tying run from second with a base hit into the outfield. A runner at second, nobody out. And this is low, ball two and one.
Sometimes it can be difficult for a pitcher. You're facing a guy that's not known to be a big stick in the lineup. Sometimes the toughest thing is to be aggressive and throw strikes.
That's a ball. And this one's low here, so the count swells to 3-1. The 3-1 pitch. And he misses there for ball four. So runners are at first and second now with nobody out.
Well, he walked him on five pitches, but that last pitch was really good. He missed down, but only by a hair. When a hitter has a 3-1 count, he can wait until he gets a pitch he loves.
So here now is the pitcher, Robbie Ray. A fairly clear sacrifice situation here with two on and nobody out. The 1-1. Is a ball as he pulled the bunt back.
Boy, he better get it back together here quick because he's got two guys on already. He's starting to lose location of that strike zone. He's got to throw a strike right here.
None out, runners at first and second. And they indeed want the pitcher to move his runners as he puts this one down. One there on to Rizzo, but a little slow in developing as they'll just get the one out.
That was kind of a high degree of difficulty play that time. You see the off-balance throw to second base, and he couldn't get a lot on it, but they did get the out.
Into the box now, Ketel Marte. Back to the fastball, but it's upstairs. Two balls and two strikes now.
Amazing he was able to lay off in this situation. Your eyes light up when you get something above the belt, especially with a man on third base.
This one's outside, quite a bit off the plate that time. Cue shot here out towards short. And he's safe. So stepping in, Eduardo Escobar, as he's got a chance to tie this ball game up with that equalizing run just 90 feet away at third. Avila at third, Ray on second, Marte is over at first with one away. Another 2-2. Had to sit back on the changeup, and he did a good job to get the bat on that one.
Don't be shocked if this pitcher tries to go a little bit further outside the zone. Three foul balls in a row. He wants to get a swing and a miss on this next pitch.
And this is on the ground to short. Could be two. Zobrist relay to first in time, and just like that, this side is retired. Just what the doctor ordered. He gets the double play to get him out of the inning. We're back to Friday Night Baseball on MLB Network after this. And back in Phoenix as we check in with Heidi Watney.
Thanks, Matt. Between innings, I was able to discuss the current state of the Cubs lineup with manager Joe Maddon. And flat out, he was very pleased with the quality of their at-bats. Yes, they've only scored one run, but he said they've done a great job of forcing the pitch count up, and he thinks that's going to lead to more offense for them as this game goes on.
Okay, thank you, Heidi. Now in the box, Anthony Rizzo, as we begin the top of the fourth. Too much bite on the breaking ball that time as it's well off the outside.
Well, that's a good pitch, but you have to get a little bit closer to the plate than that. That's that big sweeping slider. If it was a little closer, you might get a swing.
The 2-1 takes a pitch for strike number two.
He might want that pitch back up and away. That's a pitch you can really drive if you have the right approach towards that opposite field gap.
Here now, the 2-2 is a wave and a miss. He struck him out. So with that, let's call on the guys in the graphics department to put up the pitch speed comparison for the two starters. And as you see there, just 1 mile an hour separating these two arms so far. 96 on one hand, 95 on the other. Stepping into the box, Kyle Schwarber, a base hit in his first trip.
Yeah, guys, everyone knows he's been slumping. Dan, you can certainly attest to this, only amassing a solid one hit in your entire career. But pressure's off now. Maybe he gets hot. Hey, boys, you talk about getting your ace swing off. That's what it looks like right there. A guy with massive power letting it eat.
Skied into straightaway right. Jones is underneath this one. And there's the second out of the inning. And now the Cubs pitcher, Cole Hamels. He successfully laid down a sack bunt in his last plate appearance. And that misses, 2-1. Bases are empty here with two men out. Grounded up the first baseline, but this will be a foul ball as that evens things at 2-2. Line to the right side. Jones will get there and he puts it away to retire the side. Cubs are down in order. They lead it 1-0. Leading off the inning, David Peralta, as they'll look to get something going here and even this game up. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. A ball and two strikes.
So far in this game, he's the only guy in the lineup that's gone down on strikes.
Yeah, and he might strike out for a second time right here.
And a changeup swung on and missed for the first out.
Wow, that's one of the toughest pitches in baseball to hit, right? That good straight changeup, El Cambio. There's not much you can do with that. You're going off of that arm speed and the ball, it just doesn't get there.
Stepping in now, Adam Jones. Checked his swing there and pops this one up. There to take it is Rizzo, and there are two away now. Ready now for the Diamondbacks, Wilmer Flores. So far, 0-for-1 with a flyout. Hamels peers in, ready with the 1-1 pitch.
Outside, that's
can't catch the corner away with the fastball. It's 2-1.
I don't blame him for not coming over the heart of the plate. He circled this guy on the lineup card when he got to the yard today. He's been swinging one of the hotter bats in the game.
The 2-1 home. Taken, strike two. The 2-2 one more time. There's a swing and a drive hit well out to right field. Back goes Hayward. Still going back. A leap and, oh, wow, a great effort to make the play and end the inning. Another look out in right field as he ends the inning by taking away a home run. More baseball on MLB Network right after this. The next Cub up, Jason Hayward, hit it hard but lined out in his first at bat.
Yeah, Matty, but as he walks to the plate right here, he feels good building off that last AB. He hit that ball on the screws.
This is in the air out to straightaway center. Marte waits on it. He's got it one away. Now back to the top of the lineup, stepping in, Ben Zobrist. He got on top of one and was a ground out victim last time. One and two now. One run, four hits. No errors so far for the Cubbies. Maybe trying to back him up a bit there with the fastball. Swing, line drive. That's going to be trouble. Around first is Zobrist, heading for second now. And he'll reach second now with one away.
Hey, after that base knock right there, he's into double digits, D-Ro. That's a 10-game hitting streak.
Oh, you talking about double digits, Dan? Now it's getting firm. We're seeing the batting average go up. We're seeing the homers go up. We're seeing the RBIs go up. Everything is moving north.
Into the box, Albert Almora. Line to the right side. A leaping try, but it's out of his reach and into the outfield. And they won't risk it at third, so they're at the corners now with only one away.
Nice piece of hitting right there. Looked like the guy on second had to respect it and freeze a little bit.
He had to freeze there for a second to make sure that line drive gets down, but eventually does get to third base.
Standing in now, Chris Bryant. Just missed with the 2-2 count, and it runs full now.
Definitely in a tough situation facing the three hitter. You could work around him and maybe walk him to load the bases, but that just sets up the cleanup guy with the bases loaded.
Skied down the left field line. After it is Peralta. And he makes the catch in the corner. And that'll score the run from third as they go up 2-0 now.
Great job there by this power hitter. Known for driving the ball out of the ballpark. Does the job right there with the sac fly and brings the run home.
So now it'll be the four-hole hitter, Javier Baez. One for two on his line so far in the game. The 1-1 to 1-2 now. The 1-2 hit on the ground toward the left. Throw to second for the force out, and the side is retired. So a run on two hits, no errors, and a man left. Last half of the fifth coming up. The Cubs are on top 2-0.
Welcome back for the bottom of the fifth. Here's Heidi Watney.
Matt, during the commercial break, I had a chance to catch up with manager Torey Lovello about the Diamondbacks' offensive production, and he told me he's pretty unhappy with their discipline at the plate in this one. He said their pitch selection has been the main reason for their struggles today, as far too often they've been swinging at pitches outside the strike zone. That's leading to a lot of soft contact and easy outs, so the focus going forward is on shrinking the zone and forcing the opposing pitching to throw more strikes.
Thank you, Heidi. At the plate, Nick Ahmed. He leads off in the bottom of the fifth as they look to break through on the scoreboard for the first time in this one.
Yeah, baseball is a game of adjustments, and it's time they start making some. They don't need to change their entire approach necessarily, but now is maybe when they start thinking about ways to get the guy on the mound out of his rhythm a bit.
Checks his swing here, but he does so in time.
Great job to be able to lay off that pitch right there. You could tell the minute it came out of his hand, his eyes lit up at the plate.
Three balls and a strike to count to the Diamondbacks shortstop.
If you're ever going to see a position player go to the mound, it's going to be in a situation like this. Get him to relax a little bit, focus on his mechanics, and get that fastball back in the zone. Can't allow this guy to lead off walk.
Count full, three balls and two strikes. Now here's a check swing, and they appeal down to first. No swing, so that's ball four.
He almost got him to commit there. As we take another look at it in slow motion, he comes awfully close to breaking that plane, but he was able to hold back. Strong wrist, and he gets a trip to first because of it.
Stepping up to the plate, Alex Avila. He'll try to follow up the double in his last at-bat with another big hit right here.
And he's got to build off that last AB. He battled. Usually when you battle, you get in that swing mode. A lot of pitches, you'll swing at the rosin bag. I love the fact that he was able to work a double in last at-bat. Let's see if we get more of the same right here.
Two ball, two strike count to the Diamondbacks catcher.
Well, that's what you want from your curveball on one and two. You start it in the zone and let it break out of the zone where it can't be punished. Didn't get him to go after it, but the execution was nice.
Pitch on its way to Avila. Good idea with the circle change, but he lays off and the count runs full. And he will take ball four. First and second now with nobody out. And time will be called here as the pitching coach heads out to the mound and hopefully try and settle this guy down a bit. Jake Lamb standing in now. Reached base via the walk in his first plate appearance. Next pitch from Hamels tonight will be number 73 for him in the ballgame. The 3-1. A swing and a miss, and that'll fill the count at 3-2.
This offense has just been flailing at the plate all game long, so it's no wonder why they've only been able to pick up one hit so far. I'm not seeing much of a game plan from these hitters.
Now the 3-2 pitch. And he lays off there, ball four. So back-to-back walks have him in business here with nobody out.
I think he was trying to be a little too fine there, and a walk is the result. Well, the good news is he has a force at every base. The bad news, a single probably drives in a couple of runs.
Steven Souza will get a chance to really deliver off the bench here as he'll pinch hit with the bases loaded and nobody out. Ahmed, the runner at third. Avila at second. Lamb on at first with nobody out. And he lays off upstairs, but it's ruled a strike, and he can't believe it. 1-2. The 1-2 misses for the second ball.
Full count now, 3-2.
For the guy on the mound, this is one of those innings where nothing comes easy. He's thrown a bunch of pitches, and this AB hasn't been any different. Definitely laboring at the moment.
No runs, just one hit. No errors so far for the Diamondbacks. Hit on the ground to third. Oh, it takes a nasty hop, and he's unable to haul it in. And they're on the board as now it's a 2-1 ball game. Back to the top spot in the Arizona lineup now, and stepping in, Ketel Marte. He's hitless in his two at-bats so far. Ready to deal. Here's the 1-1. Fouled off. Already 24 pitches to this point in the inning. A swing, and he pops him up on the infield, and the infield fly rule will be in effect here.
I can tell you from experience, bases loaded, nobody out, and you get an infield pop-up, that feels just as good as a strikeout. And now he's just a double play ball away from getting out of this mess.
Digging in, the switch hitter, Eduardo Escobar. No hits to this point. The 1-1. Fouled away. The 1-2 misses, ball two. Bases are loaded with only one out. He's set. Here's the 2-2. And a strike three call. My gracious, what a pitch with the bases loaded, and there are two away now.
Great spot on that 2-2 fastball. You can't place it on the inside corner any better than that, and as a hitter, there's just not a whole lot you could do with that unless you're looking for it and time it just right. Love seeing a guy that can work the inside with his fastball.
Into the box now, David Peralta. Swing and a miss on the fastball, and it's 1-2.
He's got a chance to ring up back-to-back K's here, and that would be huge in this situation.
Hit hard but foul to the left, and they'll try it again. Two out, bases loaded. And a little self-preservation down at first as he pulls that one in to end the inning. So one run on one hit, no errors, and three left. We're through five here at the ballpark. The Cubbies are in front, 2-1. Andrew Chafin takes over to start the sixth inning on the mound. Riding in, Wilson Contreras. Lifetime versus this pitcher. Not a big sample size, 0-for-1. Now the 3-2 pitch. Tough pitch to lay off, but he did, and it's ball four, so the leadoff hitter is aboard to start the sixth.
That leadoff walk is a great way to start this inning when you're looking to pad the lead. Could be the beginning of good things here in this half inning.
In now, Anthony Rizzo. 0-for-2 from him so far in this one. The 1-1 hit in the air down the left field line, and this will wind up a foul ball. The 1-2. And a slider bounces, and that gets away. And forget about the double play now, as he'll move up to second here on the wild pitch.
Classic slider down and away for the strikeout there. Not a whole lot to say about that pitch that hasn't been said a million times already. That's just a real tough pitch for a hitter to pick up out of a pitcher's hand. So they end up chasing when they're in protect mode.
Stepping in now, Kyle Schwarber. Swing and a miss on the sinker, and it's 1-2. The 1-2 is looked at for ball number two. Low scoring game thus far, 2-1 here in the sixth. Pulled toward right center field. Marte is after it, but he doesn't have a chance. It's over his head. And this will bang up against the wall. The relay throw, and he is in there with an RBI triple.
Wow, with one out, and he clutches up with an RBI triple, which is his second hit of the game. So he's starting to put together a pretty big game here.
Into the box, Cole Hamels. Into the corner and slicing foul. Schwarber stands at third with one gone in the inning. Struck him out. And now they'll likely need a base hit to get that runner home from third.
Really good late bite on that slider right there. The best ones have that late action that just darts at the last minute. They're so tough to get the bat on, and when you've got that good slider going, it's a great strikeout pitch.
In now, Jason Hayward. Did a good job to shorten up and protect the plate, and he'll have another shot at it here. This is pulled into right. He leaps, but he can't get it. It's down for extra bases. And they'll extend their lead even further as the runs in to score from third, and it's a 4-1 game.
When it left the bat, I thought the outfielder had a beat on it. Gave it a heck of an effort, going high for it, but he just can't bring it down. The run came across to score, and he's safely at second, hoping his teammates can return the favor.
Standing in now, Ben Zobrist. And look out, he has to back away there and then give a little glare out to the mound. It's ball two.
Wow, fastball up and in. I'm not sure it was intended to be that far up and that far in, but message sent, beware.
Here now the 2-2. Count remains 2-2. Two out here and a runner at second. The 2-2 pitch, and this one runs in on him as he can't get his arms extended. A great pitch there, and the inning is over. So it's two runs on two hits, no errors, and a runner left. To the bottom of the sixth we go. 4, 5, and 6 coming up. It's the Cubs 4 and the D-backs 1. So here's the cleanup hitter for Arizona, Adam Jones. Due up are the 4, 5, and 6 hitters, and they're hoping that this is the part of the lineup that can get something going.
Yeah, only one run on the board so far for them. They just haven't had consistently good at-bats.
Two and one. Some action out in the bullpen. Couple of right-handers starting to loosen up. Two and two. Two balls, two strikes, a crucial count for both pitcher and hitter. So, Dan, what was your approach on the mound in that count? Do you still pitch for the strikeout here?
I think one of the keys, Matt, you want to try to initiate contact. The one thing you don't want to do, you don't want to run the count to 3 balls and 2 strikes. Whatever you want to throw, throw it over for a strike.
And he'll pull into second here with nobody out. Into the box, Wilmer Flores. He's 0 for 2 thus far in this one. No one out with a runner at second. Now a ball hit pretty well to the left, but this is going to wind up in the seats foul. The 1-2. Pitch popped up. Under it is Rizzo, one away. On his way toward the mound now is skipper Joe Maddon, and a change is forthcoming as that'll be all here for Cole Hamels. So he'll head for the showers as he stands to win this one if the bullpen can find a way to protect his 3-run lead. Xavier Cedeño, a 5'11" left-handed reliever, enters to take over on the mound now. Nick Ahmed will be his first assignment out of the bullpen as he'll stand in with a runner in scoring position at second and one away. And there's ball 3 on a breaking ball that misses away.
3-1 count, tying run on the on-deck circle. You have to be very careful right here to make a quality pitch on 3-1.
And he misses ball 4. So he comes out of the bullpen and immediately walks the first man he faces. Now to the plate, Alex Avila. It was a walk in his last trip. Jones over at second. Ahmed at first, one gone. Curveball, and he thought it was strike 2. Instead, it goes to 3-1.
There isn't a hitter alive that doesn't love hitting in fastball counts like 3-1. It's usually a pretty fruitful count in terms of getting a pitch to drive.
Just got a piece of that one. Perhaps shortening up now will get the ball in play.
Can't imagine he comes back with a third breaking ball. That hitter looked like he timed that one up pretty well and just missed it, fouling it away.
Sent out to straightaway center field. Almora in pursuit. He gets there, and that's the second out. Settling in now, Jake Lamb. It was a walk in his last trip. Sixth inning, 4-1 is our score. Fastball runs in tight here, and it's 2-1. Now the 2-1. And it's fouled away. Here now the 2-2. Is swung on and missed, strike three. Diamondbacks strand a pair. They trail it 4-1. Welcome back to Chase Field here in Phoenix. Getting set for the seventh now with the Cubs out in front. And before the inning gets underway, let's get a look at our game summary to this point. Now the skipper's on his way out toward the home plate area, and I believe that means we're going to have a double switch here. Merrill Kelly is on to pitch from the bullpen now to start inning number seven. Stepping in, Albert Almora. It was a single for him in his last at bat. The 1-1 home is taken for ball two. And now some action in that Arizona bullpen, as it looks like they'll have both a lefty and a righty up to throw. Three balls and a strike to the Chicago leadoff hitter. Chris Bryant waits on deck. The 3-1. Swung on, but it's pulled foul wide of third.
Hey, he looked like he was a little bit out in front on that breaking ball right there. The body can go a little bit. If he was able to keep his hands back a little bit, he might have been able to do some damage with that pitch.
And he popped him up. Lamb has room in foul territory. And he lays out, but he can't make the play. We'll do it again.
He was able to foul that one off, but you could tell he was definitely late. That breaking ball, the pitch before that heater right there, definitely threw his timing off.
Now the fastball is right by him as he swings and misses for the first out of the inning.
That swing tells me he was really trying to get a pitch out front and rip it down the line, but that wasn't a great pitch to do it on. It's really not the best two-strike approach either.
Stepping up now, Chris Bryant. He comes in 0 for 2 thus far.
This guy has been unbelievable. There were billboards outside Wrigley while he was still in AAA. And what does he do when he shows up? Rookie of the year, MVP. I mean, get in line.
The 2-1 home. Line drive snagged on a short hop. And they're on two away now.
Oh, man, you can't hit a ball any harder than that. I mean, this ball gets on him in a heartbeat. Nice job to stay with it, though, and then make the out at first.
Now the Cubs' four-hole hitter, Javier Baez. He's working on a 1-for-3 thus far. Two out, nobody on. Two balls and a strike to Javi Baez.
Well, it's 2-1 now, and we haven't seen a fastball from him in this at bat yet. As a hitter, you've probably got to sit on that right now.
Now the 2-1 is strike two swinging.
I think he'll be frustrated with himself about that swing. He was in a good hitter's count and ended up chasing one out of the zone. Now the count's even again.
Here now the 2-2 is laid off and the count runs full.
3-2 counts are usually a time to challenge the hitter, but I think he'll be careful here. Shoot for the corner, and if you miss and you walk him, so what? That's better than him putting one in the seats.
lofted in the air out to right field. After it is Jones. He gets there to make the play, and that ends the inning. Three up, three down for the Cubs, but they lead it 4-1. Carl Edwards Jr. gets the call from the pen to take over on the mound and start the home seventh. Into the box now, John Ryan Murphy. He's newly entered into the ballgame, so this will be his first trip to the plate here in inning number seven. The 2-1. Ball even at 2-2. And good patience to hold back on the curveball in the dirt. It's full now, 3-2.
It'd be great right here if he was able to work himself on base. You got the leadoff hitter on deck, and you know the middle of the order is coming up right behind him.
He's set. Here's the 3-2. Boy, good cutting action to that pitch as that's the first out of the inning.
Talk about blowing it by a guy. Geez, I mean, that fastball was way behind him when the swing came through the zone. I have to think he was looking for something off speed, and he just couldn't pull the trigger on that fastball.
Into the box now, Ketel Marte. Breaking ball snaps in there for a called strike two.
Hey boys, although I'd love to get all over this offense for underachieving, let's tip our cap to this pitching staff right here. They've been able to execute, work in all four quadrants, and keeping this team totally off balance.
The 1-2 gets him looking up around the letters.
No problems for him on the mound since he's come out of the pen to start this inning. That's back-to-back K's, and he's making it look pretty easy. This has the makings of a good outing so far.
Digging in, Eduardo Escobar will attempt to put the ball in play for a change here with the first two guys going down on strikes to start the inning. The 1-1 skied into very shallow right. Hayward coming on. He's there to track it down, and that'll end the inning. Diamondbacks down in order, and this is still a 4-1 ball game. Ready for another shot now, Wilson Contreras. Set and the 1-1 pitch. And the pitch misses low and away for ball two. Action now in the Arizona bullpen as they have a right-hander up and throwing. Now the 2-1 waves and misses for strike number two. The 2-2 hit the other way out toward right field. Jones is after it, and he tracks it down. Nice play for the first out. Time to give you a look now at the numbers for our two starting pitchers, and really nothing to write home about on either line as neither guy was able to last even six innings. So one gone here in the Chicago eighth, and into bat next, the left-handed hitting first baseman Anthony Rizzo. A ball and two strikes now.
Get off me, ball. That ball's way too far inside. He's got to step out of the box right now and adjust his batting gloves because he just got stung by a pack of wasps.
Got him. And that's the third time we've written a K next to his name in this one. What's your take on all the strikeouts we see in the game today, Dan? That was his third tonight, and it seems we're seeing that a lot more these days.
Yeah, Matt, there's been a real change in philosophy as far as hitting in baseball today. A lot of guys think now that an out is an out, a strikeout is just as good as a regular out, but we're seeing strikeouts at an alarming rate in baseball right now.
Stepping in now, Kyle Schwarber, high and deep down the left field line. And this will wind up a foul ball. The 1-2 popped up. Escobar is there. Makes the catch, and that'll retire the side. Cubs are down in order as they hold on to a 4-1 lead. There's Joe Maddon up out of the dugout now on his way to home plate, so it looks as though he's going to call for the double switch here. Pedro Strop will come on out of the bullpen as he'll be appearing in his third game this season. Ready once again, David Peralta. He lined out in his last trip, so looking for better fortunes here.
Yeah, pretty unlucky right there, Matty. Squared up a fastball nicely, and that's all you can do. You just want to be on time for the heater, and he's prepared for this next AB.
Doesn't want any part of that cutter, and it's full 3-2.
Good pitch right there from the reliever. Tough for hitters to do much with pitches in that location unless they're looking for it.
Pulled toward right center field. Giving chase is Almora. He gets to it and makes the catch for the first down. Had to go a long way to make that running catch, and here it is again with the show track data. Took a great angle at it, showed nice closing speed, and ended up running close to 120 feet to bring it in. No doubt that grab saved extra bases. Into the box, Adam Jones, and he fouls this one off.
I know it's a guessing game, but usually when you flip that coin, it better come up fastball at this level. You cannot be late right there. That was right in the wheelhouse.
Fouled off. Eighth inning, 4-1 is our score. Swinging a hard liner to center field, and he's going to make the play over toward his right, and there are two away now.
Well, this one was squared up pretty good, but just like pitchers give up hits on well-executed pitches, batters make outs on balls they couldn't have hit much better.
Ready for another chance, Wilmer Flores, and they're down to their final four outs here, Dan.
Yeah, and it's not looking too good for them right now, Matt. They've got a significant hill to climb, but they've got to take it one bat at a time. A couple of guys get on, and then who knows what could happen.
He's set. Here comes the 1-1. Hit down the third baseline. Balance throw gets him. Nice play there as the side is retired. So 1-2-3 go the Diamondbacks. They trail it 4-1. Now we're going to have a conference at the home plate area, so it would appear that we'll see a double switch here. Archie Bradley enters from the pen to start the ninth inning as he'll try to keep the score right where it is heading to the bottom of the ninth. Ready now, David Bodie. The 1-1 is laid off for ball two. Hit hard back up the middle. And this will make its way into center field for a base hit, and the leadoff man's aboard now to open the ninth.
Hey, this looks like it could be a potential add-on inning here in the ninth. Add-on gives some breathing room to their pitcher going into the bottom of the inning, D-Row.
Yeah, you love when the offense stays aggressive. And you also like giving your relief pitcher a chance to breathe a little bit, not having to come out there with just a one-run lead.
Standing in now, Jason Hayward. 1-2 now as that one's fouled off. The 1-2 fouled away. Bodie gets his lead at first, nobody out. Another one sent foul. Look out, that one almost got away from him. 2-2 now.
Well, what do you do when guys keep fouling pitches off like this? I guess you could back them off the plate by throwing one inside.
The 2-2 doesn't get the zone. Count full now.
These are the kind of ABs, regardless of the outcome, you go back to the dugout as an offensive player, and your teammates are loving on you for making that pitcher work and battling it out.
Ani pops it up. Peralta on the move. And no one will track it down. Another full count pitch home. Grounded down the third baseline. But this will get foul, so they'll do it again. 3-2. Another full count offering on its way. High in the air out towards shallow right. Dyson moving in. He's there and records the first down. And now back to the leadoff spot in the Cubs lineup. Stepping forward, Ben Zobrist. He'll swing it from the left side right here.
Well, if you're looking for pop, he definitely has more pop, more home run potential hitting from the left side. This is his power side.
Marte giving chase. He gets there and makes the play for the second out of the inning. Stride in again, and before he takes his cuts here, let's flash you back to the third inning. This was just a solo shot, but it definitely helped get this offense going. And the 2-1. He's fallen behind now, 3-1. The 3-1. Here's a ground ball for Ahmed at short. Reined in. Throw on the second for the force, and the side is retired. One left for the Cubs, but they lead it 4-1. Save situation looming here, and they'll hand the ball off to the hard-throwing right-hander Brandon Morrow. Digging in once again, Nick Ahmed. In prior outings against Brandon Morrow, just a couple of matchups, no hits in two at-bats. sharply hit ball back up the middle. And that's a base hit. One for two in his first couple of plate appearances. So it's a good start to the inning for the Diamondbacks. Leadoff hitters aboard.
Dan, are you kidding me right there? I mean, that had to whistle past this guy's ear. That was a scary moment.
D-Row, they call that the old chuck and duck, right? That was really close. And that's one of the things that most pitchers fear, that line drive that zipped right by your head. Wow, that was awful close.
Swing and a miss on the fastball, and that's the first out. Got him with a good high fastball there. Danny, we see a lot of that pitch in strikeout situations these days. What makes it so effective?
I think, Matt, what makes it such a tough pitch is you're changing eye levels. That fastball up looks so enticing to hit that you think you see that ball as a hitter. Do you think it can drive it? But it's really hard to get on top of that good high hard fastball.
In now, Jake Lamb. Here now the 2-2 is swung on and missed, strike three. That's back-to-back strikeouts now as they've been unable to advance that leadoff single into scoring position.
Yeah, clearly no problems working out of the stretch right now, Matt. He's taking control this inning after giving up that hit. Now we'll see if he can finish it off strong as well.
Ahmed, the runner at first with two gone. Arizona down to its last strike. And a swing and a miss as they definitely had him reaching for that one, and this ball game is over.
Yeah, that's what you want to do when you're playing on the road. Take it right to the home squad and get a win. Now the pressure is off. If they get one of the next two, the series is theirs.
A 4-1 finish in this evening's game. The Chicago Cubs led this game from the third inning on and never wavered. Cole Hamels earns the win, his second. Brandon Morrow wraps it up for the save, his 11th of the campaign. So that'll put a wrap on things here this evening. For my partners Mark DeRosa, Dan Plezak, and Heidi Watney, this is Matt Vasgersian. This has been a special presentation of MLB Network. Good night, everybody.